Money-wise, that's the second most effective, most efficient way to save, to avoid, reduce, optimize SQL Server licensing costs. For those of you who don't know, not everyone is aware of that. If you run multiple instances of SQL Server, not even databases, I'm saying instances, one SQL Server instance configured in a certain way, then another SQL Server instance configured in another way with various collation orders, master databases, schemas, then you can actually deploy them in one operating system environment. And the beauty of that is that in one operating system environment, you only need to license SQL once. You basically find the highest version, then the highest edition, and just license for that. So if you have, for example, SQL Server 2012 Enterprise and SQL Server 2019 Standard, what you need to license, I mean, you may license two of those, but sometimes if you have multiple instances, it may be cheaper to have 2019 highest version, Enterprise highest edition, assigned to the entire operating system. And that means either physical operating system or virtual operating system, but not the host, because each virtual machine is a separate operating system. So I'm talking about in the boundaries of one operating system. And I've dealt with customers who really well optimized their SQL Server estates by creating specialized, very powerful hardware clusters. Instead of deploying so-called virtual clusters where you have hosts with multiple VMs floating around the clusters, no, these are just specialized hardware boxes with just one operating system and multiple SQL Server instances inside those operating systems. You may have them like four nodes if you want it really, really well optimized for disaster recovery and high availability. If you have four nodes specialized for SQL Server, the benefits of that is basically licensing and depending on the configuration. If you have, say, two active nodes, you may even assign SQL Server Enterprise license, even SQL Server Standard licenses to that, or even without software assurance. So that is a big cost reduction. That's, by the way, a way to save on multiple SQL Server Standard instances. But what comes to mind is, because I was a DBA for a few years, what comes to mind straight away is that when you maintain that, you can't really maintain one database at a time. You need to maintain almost the whole thing. When you try to upgrade something or change something, it may affect the entire cluster with all those multiple SQL servers running support in various databases in various places. The other thing, the other concern here is security. As one of those instances, maybe I wouldn't run a payroll database. I would keep it separate somewhere. Performance is better. These clusters perform better than virtualized because you don't have all this virtualization overhead, you know, the hypervisor and stuff like that. And arguably, I'm talking from experience. And from experience, we did tests with one of the customers in the UK, and that solution was better performing, and that solution provided significant, substantial licensing cost reduction. What I need you to understand here and remember, I've spoken to technical people, and the first thing they say, by the way, we will use Docker, and we'll just isolate those SQL servers in various containers, so they'll still be inside one OEC, and can we just license it as one operating system? No, you may not, because Microsoft specifically caveated that if you isolate SQL Server in a container for the purposes of licensing SQL Server is an operating system environment. Each container is licensed separately. Don't make that mistake, please. There's a stipulation for that in the Microsoft product terms, and it's been there for a few years already. So there we go.
If you like what you've just seen, please send me a connection request on LinkedIn. The link is in the description. And please subscribe to this channel so you do not miss any of the future updates and any of the future live shows that I upload here, at least weekly. Thank you, and safe with knowledge of Microsoft licensing.